Hello everyone. First of all, I'm really sorry that, you know, no new video was there from last 3 weeks. And I want to tell you the reason why. I've been actively applying and interviewing for a lot of firms, so that kind of took my time away. And I want to inform you all that I got an offer from Salesforce. I still have some of the interviews pending, but this is the one that I got, and from rest of the firm. So if you don't know about Salesforce, just to go to the Glassdoor and check it. It has a 4.5 rating, which is pretty amazing. So now let's just get started. So what I'm going to tell here is, you know, what was the process for me like, how I applied, what were the interviews like. I'll also give you tips and tricks of how you can prepare to and how you can apply to. And I'm also going to share the brief questions that were asked to me, so that you can, you know, take up your journey and go prepare yourself. So let's just get started. So coming for how I applied. So I applied via their career section page. So I, you know, shortlisted the openings that were right for me, and I applied there. And Salesforce response was pretty amazing. Within 2 days, I think even on the next day, I got a call from a recruiter that, okay, your profile looks good for this profile, you know, the opening that you have applied for, and would you like to proceed for the process? So one thing that I was really impressed about Salesforce, that was the speed. You know, they just don't, you know, hang you on something. They will tell you whether you're selected or not. You know, the response is pretty quick. So I think when I applied after 14 days, the offer was in my hand. So they conducted all the interviews so fast and everything was so smooth. So that is one thing I would like to appreciate a lot about Salesforce. Yeah, so I applied on the career section. I got a call from recruiter. They had sent me a HackerRank link, and you know, they asked me to complete. So I think on Friday they had sent me, and they asked me to complete by the weekend. So I completed that HackerRank test on Saturday, and then on Monday I got a call whether, you know, I cleared the round or not. So they told me that I cleared the round, and the profile was sent to the hiring manager, and as soon as they get a heads up, they will, you know, schedule the interviews. So next day on Tuesday, I actually, you know, got a call again that there will be 2 interviews on the same day, and if I clear both the interviews, then I'll have a third interview which will be with the hiring manager. So it will be sort of, you know, technical and, you know, behavioral kind of interview. So I fixed a day. I think it was just after 2 or 3 days, and then, you know, I was scheduled 2 rounds of interview. So the interviews were pretty standard. First was a DS Algo round. The next was, the design round. So let me just do one thing. I have already prepared a document of what the questions were. While I'm explaining you the process, let me just tell you the questions as well. So that might help you. Okay. So let's just go there. Yeah. So as I already told you, the first was a HackerRank round. The questions asked for me was to find the median of a running stream of integers. For example, you know, you are getting like this 1, 1, 2, and you need to output the whatever the median is. Like when you have just 1, the median will be 1. When you have 1, 2, the median will be 1. And then when you have 1, 2, so these should be in the solid form, right? So don't worry if you are not familiar with these questions. Just comment down below if you want me to make, you know, another video specific to the question. So I'm just here explaining the overview, right? So this was the first question. The second question was stock span problem. So this is a pretty standard question. You can, you know, Google it, go to Geeks for Geeks, and you'll find it. I'll also make a video if you want. So these were the 2 questions, and there were standard test cases, and you had to pass the test cases. So the first round was a completely, you know, DS Algo round, where, you know, they shared a Google Doc, and I had to explain, write the code, and, you know, do a dry run with them. So first one was the rain traffic problem. This is also a pretty standard problem. Then so this is a very important problem. I'll tell you, I have given a lot of interviews, and this problem was asked to me 4 or 5 times. So by the time I did the Salesforce interview, I had already, you know, memorized this problem. So just go and, you know, have a, you know, look at my video of this rain trapping problem. So the next question was that you are given a binary tree and you are given a node. So starting from that node, how long will it take to burn all the nodes? For example, suppose there is a node. So at the first time, all the nodes that are connected at the one edge will be burned, then two edge, then three edge, and something like that. So I'll also give a detailed video of this question. Then the third problem was stock price problem. Find the start and end date. So basically you have a kind of graph kind of thing where, you know, stock prices of each day are given. So you need to find that what will be the intervals of, you know, buying and selling the stock so that your profit is maximized. So this is also a standard problem. So after this round, I was given a break of around 20 minutes and then my next round started. So next round was a mix of DS Algo and design. So design questions are mostly very abstract and you will not find very standard answers to them. I am also going to make a series on design separately that will help you a lot. So yeah, so the design question was that you are given a carpooling kind of thing like Uber and you need to design how that will work. So you know, we discussed about a lot of use cases, like, you know, if a lot of things that will be there. So basically the use case was how the cars will be assigned to a person, how the distance will be calculated, how you will combine, like for example, I am booking a ride, some other person is booking a ride, how you will decide that both the person should have one car or not. So all the scenarios were there. So the interviewer was really impressed after I answered this question. So if you want a detailed video, please comment down below. I will definitely make a video on that. And I will also discuss like what all things I discussed about the databases, servers, load balancing and stuff. So one thing before I move forward. So I was offered a MTS position, that is a SD2 position. So if you're going for a AMTS kind of a position, that is an entry level position, you will not be asked design questions. But you know, anything above SD2, you will be asked design questions. And that is not just in the case of Salesforce, but also in other companies. So if you also want to know the hierarchy that Salesforce follows in terms of, you know, the titles like SD1, SD2, SD3, comment down below. I'll make a separate video. I'll also tell you of how many experience you can apply for these positions, right? So I'm having an experience of 3 years. So that's why I applied for MTS position. Yeah. So next question was swap alternate nodes in a linked list. For example, you have 1, 2, 3, 4, right? So the answer of this will be you need to swap 1 and 3 and 2 and 4. So the answer will be 3, 4, 1 and 2. So this was the question. Then after this I got a call. So after this, you know, I got no communication, and after around 15-20 minutes I got a call from HR that, you know, if I am ready to schedule a managerial round today itself. So I said okay. So after half an hour they, you know, booked a 1 hour slot for the managerial round. So managerial round was more for first half an hour, it was behavioral questions, a lot of behavioral questions, and then, you know, why Salesforce, why I want to leave my current firm and all those things. Then in the next half he asked me technical questions. So first was like, how will I represent a polynomial and how can I add two polynomials? So this is fairly easy. Then the next question was around Facebook. So it started with how will I create a login page, what will be the backend design of it. Then he asked me small details like how will I upload an image, how will I retrieve a timeline. Then, you know, when you are chatting with somebody, you kind of see that small photo that comes with the name, right? So how that is, you know, showed. So then what kind of database I am going to use, what is the authentication mechanism. So all those questions in an incremental way about that. So also if you need a video about that, I'll discuss it. So that was the whole 1 day process. After this process was completed, after 2 days I got a call that I was shortlisted, and you know, they sent me the compensation plan. After a few discussions about the compensation and negotiation, I accepted the offer, and then now I'm on my notice period, and you know, I'm going to hopefully join Salesforce. So yeah, that was it. If you have any other questions regarding the process or anything else, any other company, anything, just comment down below. I'll be very happy to help you. And now the videos will be coming up really fast of all the series. So yeah, just subscribe to my channel and follow me. Bye bye.